And welcome back into the Sports Source, this segment brought to you by Madisonville Marine. And for the past two decades, for the majority of that, I've been wishing you a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year's on behalf of the team at Madisonville Marine. And I'm happy to do it once again. Joe Special and the crew down there are a special bunch. And I also want to say Merry Christmas to Steve Sloan, who for years and years and years was part of Madisonville Marine and has been great to me in my life. And I hope he's got a good Christmas going. All right. Let's talk very quickly here about the Tennessee-Clemson series. Tennessee leads all time 11-6-2, but only three of those games have been played since 1944. The 29-28 UT win in 1974, that's the photo at right. The 21-19 Tennessee win in 1976. And the last time these teams played was in the Peach Bowl in 2004 when Tennessee lost to Clemson 27-14. That was the day we found out what happens when a fumble rooski is run against a prowler. And it's not good for the prowler.
I need to ask Justin about the prowler.
But that photo there, I've been looking all year for a reason to put Gus Manning somehow into this show. Yeah. Gus there with the briefcase. Larry Sievers made the catch last play of the game. Tennessee beats Clemson. And Gus Manning there with the briefcase, the cigar clenched between his teeth. Gus Manning, 99 this year. So we want to wish, on behalf of everyone here and everyone in Vol Nation, we want to wish a very Merry Christmas to the great Gus Manning. And, Jimmy, I know you feel that way as well.
Absolutely.
Let's talk about Josh Heupel, what this game could mean for his national reputation, because he kind of, you know, he's been an up-and-comer, but when he came to Tennessee, people looked at it and thought, I don't know if that's going to work. This year, he won some people over. Bob, we've talked all this game, all today, about if you've beaten Notre Dame, if you've beaten LSU, Alabama, and Clemson, you've beaten Kelly, Saban, Swinney in one year with lesser talent. That's pretty big.
I think it's big for Heupel, because I think once you get past the Sabans, Kirby Smart, Day, maybe Jim Harbaugh, and I think Dabo Swinney, Lincoln Riley, they're six. I think that next part of the top 10 is kind of open. And if you win this game, this kind of maybe makes you look like a top 10 coach in the country, maybe makes you a top 10 coach in the country. And I think all of college football mostly comes back to recruiting. And boy, if your name's up there as the guy that just beat Dabo Swinney and you're in that top 10 group, I think that helps you get better players, which helps keep your name pushing up that chart. So I think it's pretty big for his national reputation.
Jimmy, let me twist it on you. That's the high. If you win, you've beaten those guys and you've kind of solidified yourself, at least in the short term, you've solidified yourself as one of those guys. Maybe not quite up to the level of the genius in Oxford, but you're pretty good. The other side of that coin, if you lose this bowl game, and granted, we're playing in an era, he coached in a bowl game that was COVID impacted. He coached in bowl games where guys can opt out and they're glorified exhibitions. But he would be 1-4 in five bowl games. And that's the thing that people start to say, well, he can't win in these games. So there is a gap between winning and losing. How big is this for his reputation?
I think he can only enhance it. I don't think he will hurt his reputation.
So even going 1-4 in five bowl games won't hurt it.
Because I didn't know that until you said it.
There you go.
So. But I think the issue would be, okay, well, he didn't have Hooker, who was the top five in the Heisman Trophy. He didn't have two of the best receivers. Mm-hmm. So I think people would look. This was an overachieving team anyway.
Yeah.
So I think he can only enhance it. I think Bob's right. If he wins it, boy, that really elevates it. But even if he loses, it's his second year at Tennessee. Dabo Swinney's been at Clemson for more than a dozen years. He's won two national championships. I really don't think he can hurt his reputation unless he gets beat 35-0.
Right. And even then, I think locally we'll look at it and say what you said, which is there are certain guys who weren't there. When you look at these, you know, he has to be considered a system-type coach. He's got his Baylor system. There aren't many of these guys who go and win at that level. The defense usually catches you up at some – it trips you up at some point. Mm-hmm. If you get to 11-2 and you've beaten LSU, Alabama, and Clemson this year and knocked off Florida – that's going to have me rethinking what you can accomplish with this system, even if it does wear out your defense.
Well, we talked about, does it have a ceiling?
Yeah.
And I think if you go 11-2 against in the SEC and then beat the ACC champion with it, I think that kind of, okay, maybe that blows the ceiling off.
Right.
Because now you're one bad game away from playing for a national championship. So I don't think it redefines it down if you lose, but it might redefine it up a little bit if you win.
Yeah, that ceiling is getting a little bit higher, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because, as you said, there were one bad game, the South Carolina game, away from being in the college football playoff.
Yeah.
Which tells me, boy, if you're that close, you know, can you get over the hump?
Catch a break or two, and it's yours. Yeah.
And I think they've done a really good job recruiting defensive players. Now, they've got, 14 kids that are practicing right now. I think 9 of them are defensive players. They got an outstanding 2 of the best defensive players in the state of Tennessee are in this class. So I think they're doing a good job recruiting defensive players. So I really like where the position of where this program is right now.
Very quickly, Jimmy, let me ask you this. You need a 30-second answer. Josh Heupel got a deal last summer. They just announced it in the middle of the season. Is a win in this game going to bounce his next deal even higher? Or do you think his next deal is going to be his next deal, regardless of 10-3 versus 11-2?
I think it could bounce it higher. And they would sign it in August and not tell us until October.
Well, there's a big value in doing that, of course. All right, very good. Hey, when we come back, if Clemson tries to take a page from Georgia's game plan against Tennessee's offense, what does that mean for the Vols? How should they respond? What did they not do well in Athens? Justin Hamilton will show you that next. Come on back on the Sports Source.
Oh, by gosh, by golly, it's time for mistletoe and holly. Tasty pheasants, Christmas presents, countryside's covered with snow.